Hi, I'm Christian. Hello and welcome to episode number 8 of Controlix Developer. Here we show you on a regular basis what Controlix automation is capable of and what kind of completely new possibilities it can offer to you. Basic requirements for an open and future-proof platform are standardized and state-of-the-art interfaces. To explain to you how Controlix Core works with the REST interface, I have invited Johannes. Hello, Johannes. Nice to have you here to explain to us yet another topic.
Hello, Christian. Many thanks for the warm words.
You've explained to us already some software topics like the data layer, the SDK.
Yes, you're right.
You can find all the developer episodes in the playlist or linked in the description below. Now, it's all about the REST interface. What role does it play?
As you might know, REST stands for Representational State Transfer. And using the REST interface, that it's possible to dock web-based apps to Controlix Core very easily. And since we have chosen a lot of web-based services for the architecture of our Controlix, REST was essential.
Okay. Now enough of your buzzwords. How can our valuable customers make use of it?
So not only the valuable customers can make use of it, we use the REST interface too to manufacture our controls. And one other example is the automated configuration of serial machines.
Okay, now I understand it too. This sounds like infinite possibilities, especially in comparison to conventional PLCs, right?
Yes. In previous platforms, there are particularly only the interfaces that the control supplier has provided. If you need a new interface, the supplier has to program it. Web-based has simply not played a role so far.
Let's get started.
What I can show you is how to configure machines even faster and better, how REST works together with the Controlix data layer, and how to create whole dashboards using Node-RED.
Then let's do it.
Okay, I start with access to my Controlix Core. I have now launched my virtual control. And after I log in successfully, we see here all the main functions, and all these functions have their own API. For example, installing packages or changing IP addresses or creating some users.
Right. This is what Kai already demonstrated in episode number 2 when he set up his Controlix Core, right?
Yes. And as you can see, I can create a new IP address for this Ethernet adapter, for example. Here I can add this IP address. And all this could be done with a REST client too.
But why don't you use this interface? It looks quite user-friendly.
Sure it is. But what happens if you want to configure not one control, but 10?
You should tell me.
Yes. You can, for example, write your own program or use a tool that runs directly on your PC. And with this tool or program, you don't have to click through the network manager 10 times. You can use this program and configure 10 controls.
That's pretty clever, but of course it gets even better.
You got it. We already deliver the different APIs for our web services. These are addressable, and so I can see right away what I can do with the individual APIs. I can show you this one. If we go back to our landing page, we can click to the API reference, for example, to the packet manager, and here we see the whole API of the packet manager.
Okay. So here you can use the APIs directly without clicking through the graphical user interface of the control?
Correct. I can show you the installed packages, for example. So of course, I have to authorize. Now I'm authorized. And here we see the list of the installed packages. I can click try it out, execute, and here we see the response. All with the installed packages.
But the administration and the setup of the Controlix Core is only a small part of the possibilities which we have with the REST interface.
Just right. Because in addition to the APIs for administration, we also have a REST API for everything that is available on the Controlix data layer.
Exactly. For those of you who don't know what the data layer is...
You are in the wrong video.
No, you stay here. Just briefly. The data layer is our data backbone that connects all the apps. And we have a dedicated episode where Johannes explained how it works.
Exactly. and because everything that is available in the ControlX data layer is accessible via the REST interface. So developers can adapt this interface dynamically and address the data.
Wow. Can you show us?
Sure. So let's get back to the data layer tree. Here we see our well-known data layer tree. And if I now register a new data provider, we can have access to this data via the REST interface.
That's right. We have already mentioned how to register a new data provider in episode number 5 of the ControlX developer series.
Sure, but that's not all. I still have an application example with me that shows the benefits of our new platform and the open interfaces.
Okay, now it's getting exciting.
You can say that again. I assume Node-RED is familiar to you, Christian?
Sure, it runs at home on my Raspberry Pi. It's a graphical IoT development software.
Exactly, a low-code environment, as it's called. With ControlX automation, with our modularity and with the REST APIs, the machine builder can write his own commissioning tool, for example, for a very specific group of users that are not familiar with programming his own software.
For example, for a technician who has to do the pre-commissioning of a machine.
For example.
So how does it work?
We built ourselves a simple dashboard using Node-RED. I have installed the Node-RED application on my ControlX core. I can show you. Inside of our Node-RED application is a palette Node-RED Contrib ControlX Automation pre-installed. But you also can download it. It's available online. With this extension, there is a new data layer request node. And with this node, we simply can use the data layer. I will show it later live. Here I prepared a flow to show you a little demo. As you see here, with this flow, we build a simple dashboard. For example, for your electrician who has to set up a machine control. You might remember this application?
It looks like our 3-axis kinematics.
Exactly. This can work like a simple setup wizard just by clicking the mouse.
Okay, for example, you can create the configuration for a specific machine. You simply take the layout of an ordered machine and you create all the required access here even before the machine really exists.
Correct. Quite simply by clicking through step by step here, for example. We can automate machine configuration very quickly and easily.
And make it usable for people who are not familiar with ControlX works.
Right.
So a technician could move all the access during commissioning even before the software developer has finished his project.
Like you said, infinite possibilities.
Cool. Can you show us now?
Yes, of course. Pay attention. So now I open the dashboard. Let's go to the system overview. Here I have created a simple dashboard. First, I have to create the access, and we see the axes are created. After that, we can create the kinematic called robot. Now the next step is add these axes to our kinematic. After that, we can switch the motion state to running. After that, we are able to power on the robot, and now we can group the robot. And now we see the axes are in coordinated motion. Now we are able to move the axes. Switch to another overview. Here I've created 3 buttons with 3 different positions, and here are the X positions of the axis X, Y, and Z. So let's move the axis, and now we see here the virtual axes are moving.
It's amazing how easy it is.
Yes, all compatible and programmable thanks to our REST interface. But of course, it is no must. All this can be done with a PLC program, but you know, it's not my favorite way.
So we defined our own nodes to make the REST interface of ControlX Core work easier together with Node-RED.
Exactly. Own nodes and flows with which you can start immediately. I have an example to demonstrate this with a ControlX data layer. Let's go back to the administration overview. So we add a new flow, pick and trigger command and a debug node, and we go to our data layer request node, just connect it. So here, and now we have to set up this node. I prepared the virtual control 1. You have to pick up your device and select browse, for example, and here you can click and see the whole data layer. Just by adding the path, I can browse the new root node. And of course, you know it, you have to deploy this. And then we can trigger and we see here is the whole data layer.
A really neat example of how easy and modular you can program, automate, exchange data with the help of the REST API of the ControlX core. So to sum it up, what did we see today?
So ControlX automation uses web-based architecture as basis to keep the system modular and open. And we have different interfaces to access our control. We have explained this with a simple example using the packet manager. In addition, we also have the possibilities to program apps and extend the interfaces ourselves. And so we are able to give others access to our software. And last but not least, we showed with Node-RED how simple it is to program own dashboards for machine operators, for example.
Wow, this is quite a lot. Thanks, Johannes, for this deep dive into the possibilities which the REST interface can offer to us.
I'm always happy to explain something to you.
And we'll see you again on December 10th to show you how the ControlX automation community can help you with all your automation needs. If you have any further questions on the REST API, just leave a comment and we're happy to get in touch with you. One tip from my side, click on the subscribe button so you won't miss the next episode. Until then, catch you on the next one to be two steps ahead.